Hello, everyone. I'm Diet Le. I'm an associate professor of research at Intermountain Health and a preventive cardiology PA. And I work closely with patients across the entire spectrum of cardiovascular disorders. And today I wanted to talk to you about something that's become an increasing important issue in both primary and specialty care, and that is cardiovascular kidney metabolic health, otherwise known as CKM. As PAs, we're often first to spot the patterns in our patient's health. And CKM is one of those patterns that's highly associated with poor outcomes, but also where early detection can make a real difference. So let's dive in. CKM is a systemic disorder. It's driven by complex interactions between metabolic risk factors, chronic kidney disease, and the cardiovascular system. These interactions can lead to multi-organ dysfunction and a high rate of adverse cardiovascular outcomes. This includes patients who are at risk for cardiovascular disease, as well as those who already have it. The clinical implications of this, well, they're significant. These include premature mortality, excess morbidity, multi-organ disease, and high healthcare costs. Largely, this is due to cardiovascular disease. Metabolic abnormalities like insulin resistance and inflammation, they play a key role in how the heart and the kidney affect each other. And kidney dysfunction is now recognized as a major mediator between metabolic risk and cardiovascular disease, especially with heart failure. In fact, in my experience, every patient with heart failure, or nearly every patient with heart failure, has CKM, and vice versa. So, what can we do? One simple tool we should be using more often is the urine albumin creatinine ratio, or UACR. It's a powerful predictor of cardiovascular risk, especially in patients that have diabetes, heart failure, coronary artery disease, and hypertension. CKM is also a public health urgency, with rising rates of obesity and diabetes in both adults and children. We're seeing disparities across age, sex, ethnicity, and socioeconomic status. These same factors drive CKM, ultimately cardiovascular disease. To help us better understand and intervene, the American Heart Association released the 2023 presidential advisory proposing a staged approach to CKM management. Stage zero is no CKM risk factors. Stage one describes excess or dysfunctional adiposity. Patients may be overweight or obese with elevated glucose or A1C. Stage two are metabolic risk factors and CKD. So think type 2 diabetes, hypertension, hypertriglyceridemia, and metabolic syndrome. Then there's stage three, which is cardiovascular disease that is subclinical. Now, patients may have overlapping CKM risk factors or very high-risk CKD. Lastly, stage four. This is clinical cardiovascular disease. This includes coronary artery disease, heart failure, stroke, PAD, or atrial fibrillation. Now, in my particular practice, we often see patients referred already with stage three or four. But with earlier screening, we can intervene sooner with the goal of halting or even reversing cardiovascular disease. So here's the takeaway. CKM, it's complex, but it's something we can act on. And we as PAs, we are trained and we need to recognize those risk factors. We need to screen appropriately and stay informed. In the next video, we'll talk about medications and treatment strategies for CKM and its comorbid conditions. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.